Hey everyone, my name is Cass and today we are talking about the HTC Vive Cosmos, yes, again. But this time we won't have the inside-out tracking issues as we are reviewing the Vive Cosmos Elite that comes with the external tracking faceplate included. The faceplate supports the base stations, also known as the lighthouses, and this is still one of the most accurate tracking systems to date. Is this going to make a difference for the Cosmos headset? Let's find out. But first, if you'd like to see more videos like this one, subscribe if you haven't yet to support us, and now join me beyond reality. Okay, so a lot has been going on with HTC Vive lately. Let me summarize relevant information so you understand where this review fits. In February, HTC announced that they are releasing three new headsets in the Cosmos series: the Vive Cosmos Play, Vive Cosmos Elite, and the Vive Cosmos XR. These headsets will replace the Vive Pro, as the Pro has been discontinued for consumers. The Cosmos Play and XR have no release date yet, but the Vive Cosmos Elite is already available for pre-order in the US and from now also in Europe and the UK. The Elite should start shipping at the end of this month, depending on where you live. Before all this, the first Cosmos headset came out a couple of months ago and it looks like this. This is the version that supports inside-out tracking using these six cameras on the headset. You also get these controllers with it. This is the Vive Cosmos Elite. The specifications of this headset are very similar to the first Cosmos headset. Here's an overview. As you can see, the display is the same, both LCD panels. The headsets have the same Fresnel lenses, the same resolution, field of view, refresh rate, strap and flip-up design. There's a manual IPD adjustment on both headsets here. The most obvious difference is the color, but the most important differences are the controllers and the faceplates, which allow for different tracking methods. The Elite faceplate supports external tracking, while the faceplate of the first Cosmos supports inside-out tracking. Both faceplates are exchangeable, so you could put the external tracking faceplate on the first Cosmos and vice versa to change the tracking methods. Although this does make everything more expensive, as you will need the base stations and compatible controllers to use the external tracking faceplate. While the other faceplate only works with the Cosmos controllers. Yes, I know, it gets pretty complicated this way, so if you have any questions about this, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Also, a quick note, I'm not making a separate full review of the first Cosmos, as most specifications are the same anyway, so this video should work as the review for the first Cosmos 2 on those specs, just not for the inside-out tracking performance. For that, you can check out my previous videos, I've linked it in the description. It's time to move to my thoughts on the Cosmos Elite headset. We'll talk about its look and feel, performance, display, the usual stuff. But first, this is what comes in the box. The Cosmos Elite includes a pre-installed external tracking faceplate, two SteamVR base stations version 1.0, and two first-gen Vive Wand controllers. To connect the headset's cable to the PC, you put it in this converter that uses DisplayPort and USB 3.0 cables. The box also comes with a mini DisplayPort to DisplayPort adapter. Of course, the Vive controllers and base stations come with its accompanying power adapters. The Vive controllers are charged with a micro USB cable, and the base stations come with a mounting kit that has two mounts, four screws, and four wall anchors. I've shown you the Elite a bit already, but before we move on to the more techy part, I wanted to talk about its look and comfort first. The headset comes with this removable face cushion foam, and for your forehead, there's leather foam padding. It uses a halo design that you might recognize from the Oculus Rift S and PSVR. I do find the Cosmos Elite harder to get comfortable though. The headset tends to lean on my forehead, causing discomfort after a long play session. So I would say this headset is less comfortable than the Rift S, PSVR and the Valve Index, however it is for sure more comfortable than the original HTC Vive with its original straps. However, as I always say, comfort is a very personal thing, so it might be different for you. Let's move on to its display now, but before that, don't forget to drop us a like on this video for support. So according to HTC, the Elite uses all new LCD panels, which reduces the distance between pixels and minimizes the screen door effect. And when compared to the original HTC Vive, it is for sure a noticeable difference. Screen door effect is almost gone, not entirely, but I don't mind it at all. The display also features a 2880x1700 pixel resolution, which is an 88% increase over the original Vive. However, it isn't much of an increase when compared to the Oculus Rift S, Valve Index, or even the HTC Vive Pro. So yes, compared to the original Vive, a huge increase in clarity, visuals are much sharper, reading text is much easier, but when compared to the Rift S, you can see a difference, but it's not as big as with the original Vive. I honestly don't think you will notice the difference as much when playing games, unless you play racing or flight simulators where the higher resolution can make a big difference. When compared to the Valve Index, I think the Index has a better overall display. The refresh rate is still 90Hz and, well, yes, it still works and performs excellent. As for the lenses, the Cosmos still uses Fresnel lenses. So yeah, glare and God rays are still there in high contrasted scenes, but it doesn't bother me for comparison. It is more noticeable on the Valve Index. The sweet spot is, however, for some reason tinier than I remember from the original Vive. It makes staying in the sweet spot a challenge, especially when I'm playing fast-paced games like Pistol Whip, where I dodge and duck very often. The headset easily moves me out of the sweet spot. I don't seem to have this problem as often with other headsets. The view-to-view is the same as the original Vive. HTC says it's 110 degrees, but that's usually the maximum and I could never get it as high as headset manufacturers say. So I usually measure it in this test app, and this time I measured 88 degrees horizontal and 106 degrees vertical, and only when I wear the headset very tight. Usually I get less FOV and it feels like the HTC Vive and the Oculus Rift. This FOV is still fine for me. The interpupillary distance, or IPD, adjustment is fortunately manual. Using this dial at the side, you can move the lenses closer and further away from each other to match the distance of your eyes, and it helps tremendously to get your image sharp. The IPD range for the Elite is 61 to 73.4 millimeters. My IPD is around 59, and I can play well on the lowest IPD setting, although I am wondering now if the sweet spot is tinier for me because I can't get the IPD range closer to my eyes. When you wear the headset, I almost don't see any light leakage from the nose cap either, especially when you wear it tight, but you can still see a bit of your floor if you really try. Of course, you can now use the flip-up visor to quickly check what's going on in real life, which all the other headsets do not have. The flip-up visor is a nice feature, especially for quick peeks. I don't think it's comfortable though wearing the headset with the visor up for a longer time. As for tracking, I mentioned it already, it uses the SteamVR tracking with base stations, and this is made possible with the external tracking mod that's included with the Elite kit. The front faceplate is the external tracking mod. To detach it, you have to turn the headset around, and next to the left lenses, there's a button that you can press down. While holding this button down, you should be able to remove the faceplate with ease. To mount this faceplate again, or any other faceplate you might have, just make sure to align the port and the pins accordingly, and then you can firmly press around the faceplate to mount it. Make sure the faceplate aligns with the headset from all sides. The external tracking faceplate can be used with base station 1.0 and 2.0, as well as with the original Vive or Vive Pro controllers. This means that if you already have the base stations, you don't need to buy new ones, you can just get the headset only. What can I say about tracking performance any more than what you already know from me? If you follow this channel, you know I like this tracking system. The SteamVR base station tracking, when mounted correctly, is one of the most accurate tracking systems to date. The downside here is that it is more effort getting it set up initially, but once done, you never have to touch it again for it to work correctly. Another downside is that you cannot easily bring your setup with you to your friends, so the headset isn't as portable as an inside-out tracking headset. Let's move on to the controllers. These are the original Vive controllers, also known as the Vive Wands, and let me be blunt, I don't like them. They are bulky and not ergonomic. These controllers are seen as first-gen controllers, and it has a lot of issues like the trackpad stops working after a while and the grip buttons are not very well placed. The newer touch controllers, or the Valve Index controllers, are just much more intuitive to use and more comfortable. I wish HTC had reiterated the controllers and brought out new ones, but because the Elite uses the base stations, you can use any SteamVR compatible controllers with it, so you can also get the Index controllers with your Cosmos Elite, for example. As for audio, I think they are fine. I'm not an audiophile though, but this setup is definitely better than the speakers of the Rift S. I think it sounds about the same with the deluxe audio strap. I do find the audio solution by the Valve Index tons better. The microphone sounds like this.
This is an uncut and unedited recording from the HTC Vive Elite microphone. Press the pants and sew a button on the vest.
This sounds like the original Vive microphone, and it isn't very good. And for those that wear glasses, most should be able to fit in the headset. I tried it with these glasses that have pretty big frames. You can get the Vive Cosmos Elite kit for $900. There's an option to get the headset only for $549 for those that own the base stations and controllers already. At the time of making this video, you can get Half-Life Alyx and a 6-month Viveport Infinity membership for free with your Cosmos Elite kit, which is a pretty good deal. This offer ends on June 30th. So overall, I think the Vive Cosmos Elite is decent, it performs well and it feels fine. It is for sure an upgrade if you come from the first gen headsets like the original HTC Vive or original Rift. However, there are other headsets out there that will offer you better value for the same money or even less, which makes it hard to recommend this headset over others. The Valve Index, for example, goes for $999 for a full kit. It is $100 more, but it offers a lot more improvement in almost every aspect. The Valve Index also provides a headset-only option for $499, which is even cheaper than the Elite headset-only option. So there's really no reason to get the Cosmos Elite over the Valve Index if you already own the base stations. The Oculus Rift S is $400, and while the Cosmos Elite has better specifications, I think the Rift S can give you almost the same kind of VR experience for half the price. There is a reason why you could get the Elite, and that is for the wireless adapter. This adapter allows you to play PC VR games wirelessly, which can feel pretty great, but the wireless adapter is $350 on top of the Elite price. It will be interesting to see what else HTC does with their modular approach though. The mods might offer a better value in the future when they allow you to do things other headsets can't. But right now, HTC's prices are unfortunately not competitive enough. I know that some of you don't like Oculus headsets and are not able to buy a Valve Index in your country, so there might be people set on getting an HTC headset. Then I would recommend getting the Cosmos Elite and not the inside-out tracking Cosmos, and especially if you already own base stations or controllers. Some of you asked about the Vive Pro, and I think the Pro is still a great headset and has an arguable advantage over the Elite, which are its OLED displays. Some people prefer the deeper blacks, and I agree it looks better, but I don't mind the grayer blacks with LCD panels, plus LCDs have the advantage of being able to provide more subpixels than OLED, resulting in greater sharpness for the same rendering costs and less screen door effect. This difference is very noticeable when compared with the Elite display, and since the Vive Pro is being discontinued for consumers, I do not recommend getting the Vive Pro anymore. For now, let's wait and see what HTC does with their modular approach. I will for sure keep you updated on this channel, but soon on the channel I will review the wireless adapter for both Cosmos headsets. I know some of you are interested in this. So, what do you think about the Cosmos Elite? Do you agree or disagree with my points? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching this video. If you want to know more about other VR headsets, then check out this playlist right here. Hope to see y'all in the next video, and a special thanks goes to our right-hand patron. Special thanks goes to Backstone VR. Support him supporting us by checking out his channel and maybe subscribing. And as always, VR on. Oh. But this time we won't have the inside-out tracking issues, as we are not sure if you can hear that. Let's do this again.